Hello all, my name is Yorgos Aguirreou and I work in the Knowledge Representation, Reasoning and Analytics team of Professor Manolis Koumbarakis for the University of Athens. We are partners of the Big Data Europe Research Project and we are technical leaders of the Societal Challenge 7 of the Big Data Europe related to security. Along with our direct partners, the NCSR Demokritos and Satsen, we created the pilot application I am going to present you. The SC7-Pilot provides one entry point and two main workflows to the user, the change detection workflow and the event detection workflow. About the change detection workflow, we start with the sextant, which provides a graphic user interface and is also the entry point of the SC7-Pilot. The qualified user selects a region on the map two different dates of interest. Sextant makes a query towards image aggregator, which searches for the appropriate satellite images on Copernicus Open Access Hub of ESA by sending a query to it. It finds the images and downloads them. In the next step, image aggregator stores the images in the HDFS and also initiates the change detector, which is an image processing component that runs on Apache Spark. The change detector reads the images from the HDFS, processes them, and finds areas on the ground that have changed. When the processing ends, it returns the results for visualization to Sextant and also stores them to Strabon by sending them through GeoTriples. GeoTriples is a tool that converts data to RDF. Now, I'm going to present you how the change detection workflow looks like from the user's point of view. The qualified user enters the pilot, selects change detection, specifies the area that wants to search for changes, enters a layer title, two dates, one in the past and one more recent. The user also has to create an account on Copernicus Sci-Hub and starts the change detection. Image aggregator searched for the images, found the images and starts downloading them. When the download ends, the images are stored in the HDFS and then the change detection that runs on Spark is triggered. And also the DB scan that also runs on Spark. The change detection and DB scan reads the data and get the result. Then change detection is completed. And that's how the SC7-Pilot looks from the user's point of view. Now, the event detection workflow. At first, I'm going to explain how this workflow is supported and then go to the actual workflow. In contrast to the change detection workflow, the event detection is not totally on the fly, but needs some time to be prepared in order for the new scroller to search for tweets and news articles, and for the event detection component to process them and then define and store the events. So, before the user selects an event detection, the news crawlers are already running, crawling the web, and getting news articles from Reuters based on RSS feeds and tweets from specific Twitter accounts. then stores all of them in a Cassandra instance, making them available for the event detector component. While the event detector is processing data from Cassandra, in order to create an event, it needs to specify the coordinates of locations it finds in the data. So it queries the lookup service and sends location names, and the lookup service then sends back polygon with coordinates of each location. Also, in cooperation with the Semantic Web Company, the event detector sends queries to the pool party about the entities, and the pool party sends back the entities regarding each event. When the events are ready, are stored through geotribs to Strabon as RDF. In the meantime, Semagrow is running. It federates Cassandra and Strabon and provides unified access to them. Now, everything is ready for the user to initiate an event detection. The user can ask for events, use restrictions for them by selecting a certain area in the map, or a date window, or a keyword, and Sextant sends queries to Strabon and Cassandra through Semagrow. Strabon and Cassandra send back the events and the sources of the events, respectively, through Semagrow to Sextant, and all of them are visualized for the user. Now I'm going to show you how the event detection looks like from the user's point of view. The user has already selected an area, this one, and initiates an event detection based on this area. Sextant, all the backend is running, and the events are returned to Sextant. These are the events. These are the sources of an event stored in Cassandra. And event areas, event images, and event entities are the extra information for each event. The user can see areas related to the event. It also can see images from Flickr related to event, or event entities that we are getting from the pool party. And that's how event detection looks like from the user's point of view. Next, we have two requirements for the SC7 pilot. First, the whole pilot application has only one entry point, the Sextant. The user should not be able to affect the workflow. The whole application should be solid. Also, for running the whole application, we need a lot of resources because more than 20 Docker containers are running to support it, and some of them are pretty demanding in resources. Also, the workflows are tightly implemented and a lot of components are used by both the workflows. Because of the tight implementation, we have different levels of dependency among the software components that all of them run inside on one or more Docker containers in a Swarm cluster. Now, we are going to see the levels of dependency among the components. For running Sextant, Docker containers of Event Retrieve, Postgres, and Aggregator Detector should be up and running. And for running them, Docker containers of Semagrow and Hadoop and Spark should also be up and running. Walking more to the backend, Docker containers of Cassandra, Strabon, and GeoTrip should be up and running. And for supporting them, Docker containers of PostGIS and Strabon should be up and running. In the upper section, there are some of the Dockers that support the event detection workflow. Down, there are all the Dockers that support the change detection workflow. While in the middle, there's only one, the Docker container of Postgres, that makes Sextant capable of letting only authorized users to use it. Now, we are going to see the levels of dependency among the components that support the event detector component. For using the event detector, Dockers of Cassandra, Lookup Service, and GeoTribbles must be up and running. In the next level, New Scrollers and Docker Strabon should be running. And in the last level, PostGIS Docker should be up and running to support Strabon. The upper section, there are components that retrieve and store data. The data are then processed by the event detector. Down, there are components that are used for storing the results of the event detector that we call events. While in the middle, there is only one Docker container, the one of Lookup Service, that offers the location extraction needed by the event detector. For running all the software components efficiently, we have to think backwards. When each component is running, the ones that provide its backend support should be up, running, and last but not least, they should be healthy. So we will see the sequence for launching all of them and divide the Docker containers in several groups based on the level of priority in launching. At first, we can run the completely dependent and fully backend Docker containers of Lookup Service, Postgres, Cassandra, PostGIS, and Hadoop. When they are ready, the new scrollers can run and store in Cassandra. Strabon can also run, that is based because it is based on PostGIS. And all the Dockers of Spark can run. Usually there is one Spark master and three or four workers. And when a Spark job is committed, the Spark job can read data from the HDFS. Cassandra's Strabon is up and running, so Semagrow can start and federate them. In the next level, Cassandra is running and possibly already has data gathered by the new scrollers. Lookup Service is already running and can serve the location extraction. If event detector demands it and GeoTribbles with the whole backend is also running, so the event detector's result can be stored. So event detector now can start because all of its backend is now ready. Also, the event retrieve service that bridges Sextant to Semagrow can also start running. And the aggregator detector that involves image aggregator, which downloads the images and stores them to HDFS and commits the Spark jobs, that can also start running because HDFS and Spark are already running. At the end of this chain, everything that supports Sextant is ready, so Sextant can also start running. Having all of these in mind, we can create the docker-compose.yml file with health checks for all Docker containers added so that it can start all the containers of the SC7-Pilot safely and in the right sequence. By using health checks, we can define both the launching sequence and also be sure that before launching a certain container, all the ones that provide its backend are not only up and running, but also healthy. Also, if something goes wrong, we can see which of the containers causes trouble. Here you can see a quick view of the docker-compose.yml that defines all the Docker containers of the SC7-Pilot. We have Sextant with its dependency, 1, 2, and 3. We have Postgres, which is independent, so only health check applies to it. Event retrieve, which depends on SemaGrow, and also this is its health check, and more. University of Athens, NCSR Demokritos, and Satsen worked together for the creation of the pilot. You can go in this URL to see more details about it. This is the site where we have all the information regarding the pilot. Thank you much for your attention.